Engineering, Batch 11. Our project title is Study on Removal of Nutrients from Aqueous Environment Using Strychnus Potatorum Seeds by J. Janfi Rani, S. Vishnupriya, E. Supriya, under the guidance of Mr. R. Jayakumar. Introduction. Wastewater contains solids, heavy metals, nutrients, and pathogens. The two main macronutrients present in wastewater is nitrogen and phosphorus, and their main sources are human waste, foods, soaps, and detergents, runoffs from agricultural land, etc. If untreated, wastewater left into water bodies, nutrients such as nitrogen and phosphorus can cause unwanted algal and plant growth. It also affects the aquatic organisms. In the wastewater treatment, the most commonly used chemical coagulants are alum, ferric chloride, and polyaluminium chloride, as the disadvantages such as high cost, ineffectiveness in low temperature, and large stretch production, etc. To overcome these problems, here natural coagulants are used. They are obtained from the various parts like roots, seeds, fruits of the plants. Benefits of using this type of natural coagulant are cost effective, biodegradable, less voluminous sludge, clarified turbid water, and also for removal of heavy metals and nutrients. Example, Strychnus potatorum, generally called as a clearing nut tree, and Bacillus vulgaris, common bean, Moringa oleifera, drumstick. Strychnus potatorum. In our project, we are using the natural coagulant called Strychnus potatorum. Over 4,000 years ago, it was first reported that plant-based coagulants are used for water treatment. It is an indigenous plant largely seen in southern and central parts of India. The seed extracts or destabilize the particles by interparticle bridging. It contains lipids, carbohydrates, and alkaloids containing the carboxyl and free hydroxyl surface group, which enhance the coagulant capability. It has metal bindings and clarifying properties. It is also used for many medical purposes such as diabetes, scorpion bite, high disease, ulcer, dysentery, etc. These are the sample pictures of the natural coagulant. First figure shows the Strychnus potatorum fruits, and the second picture shows the Strychnus potatorum seeds. Objectives: to remove the nutrients from aqueous environment using natural coagulants such as Strychnus potatorum seeds. To optimize the different operating parameters such as pH, coagulant dosage, contact time for the maximum removal. To determine the removal efficiency of Strychnus potatorum seeds. Need for study. It is an important process in meeting high quality effluent requirement. Excessive levels of nitrogen and phosphorus disrupt the natural environment and can affect the health of our water system. It is cost effective and feasible for all the types of people. It is necessary to remove the nutrients by using natural coagulant because it produces less voluminous sludge, so it does not affect the environment in any cast. Literature review. Enhancing filtrate quality of turbid water, incorporating seeds of Strychnus potatorum, pads of Cactus opuntia, and mucilage extracted from the fruits of Coccinea indica as coagulant by C. Nirmala Rani. In this paper, the turbid water is made by kaolin with high turbidity of 192 NTU. NTU is nothing but nephelometric turbidity unit. After adding different dosages of natural coagulant as 1.5 mg per liter, 30 mg per liter, and 0.5 mg per liter, the supernatant from the settled water as the turbidity range up to 14 NTU for Strychnus potatorum seed, 17 NTU for Coccinea opuntia, and 13 NTU for indica plant, followed by filtration to measure head loss and turbidity. Then the filtrate water ranges becomes 0 NTU, 1 NTU, and again 0 NTU. The second literature review refers to the title named as Moringa oleifera and Strychnus potatorum seeds as natural coagulant compared with the synthetic common coagulant in treating car wash wastewater by RMS Redin Mohammed, In this experiment, we can see that a standard jar test carried out for coagulation and flocculation study, the mixture started with a rapid mixing of high RPM for 10 minutes and then followed by slow mixing at the low RPM for 30 minutes. Then this coagulant was allowed to settle for 60 minutes. In this, we can find that the effective percentage of removal of different parameters even with a lower dosage of 40 to 80 milligram per liter and Moringa aurifera with a turbidity removal of 94% and COD removal of 60% and phosphorus removal of 81%. And in the natural coagulant of Strychnos polyterum seeds, we can see turbidity has been removed to 97% and COD up to 54% and phosphorus 82%. Evaluation of performance of natural Strychnos polyterum over the synthetic coagulant alum for the treatment of turbid water by Dr. B.S. Deshmukh. In this paper, they studied that the reduction in the turbidity level, which depends upon raw water turbidity, the Strychnos polyterum was found to be effective when used in low dosages up to the level of 0.25 to 0.35 mg per liter. And it acts as a coagulant and coagulant aid at high turbidity up to the range of 1000 to 3000 NTU. The prepared solution of Strychnos polyterum was kept 4 days in refrigerator. The removal efficiency is better on second day and then deteriorates on third day, and fourth day depends upon the initial turbidity of water sample. The next literature review refers to the title named as Protein from Natural Coagulant for Potential Applications of Turbidity Removal in Water by G. Muthuraman. In this experiment, the natural coagulants such as Moringa aurifera, Strychnos polyterum, Bacillus vulgaris seeds are treated with different solvents of sodium chloride and sodium hydroxide to extract the active coagulant agent. The maximum turbidity removal efficiency obtained for Moringa aurifera at 12 hours retention time in the settling column for 100 NTU, 250 NTU, 500 NTU with the initial turbidity removal efficiency are as 95.93%, 95.10%, 99% respectively. 0.5 molar concentration sodium extract was found to provide high turbidity removal of less than 99% compared to sodium hydroxide and distilled water extract. And the next literature review has the title named as Studies on Strychnos polyterum seed and Screening the Water Quality Assessment of Drinking Water by N. Bhakyalakshmi. The effectiveness of Strychnos polyterum in the removal of turbidity, total oddness, pH, total dissolved solids has been investigated in this experiment. The seed column compounds were tested for antibacterial properties against some pathogenic gram-positive and some gram-negative bacteria. And these growth of Proteus vulgaris, Pseudomonas aeruginosa, and Staphylococcus aureus, Staphylococcus epidermis were significantly inhibited. And the next literature review named as A Study of Strychnos polyterum as a Natural Coagulant for Treatment of Textile Wastewater by P. Sudha. In this experiment, they are using pre- and post-treated textile wastewater as a sample. And this experiment deals with various proportions of Strychnos polyterum, such as alum-like with a ratio of 0:0, and up to the ranges has been represented in the slide, and are used to evaluate the maximum removal. From the results, 40:16 has more potential for the removal of pollutant in textile waste. The next review deals with the removal of turbidity from washing machine discharge using Strychnos polyterum seeds. Parameter of Optimization and Mechanism Prediction by B. Senthil Kumar. In this study, the performance of the system is compared with the washing machine discharge. The synthetic turbid water ranges from 50 to 145 NTU. They found that the percentage of removal of turbidity lies between 68 to 89% for Strychnos polyterum and 65 to 84% for synthetic turbid water at an ideal pH of 6 to 7. The experiment values are compared with the Langmuir and Friedlich isotope models to understand the extent of influence of sorption of the particles on the strychnos potatorum seed powder. Coagulant preparation. Strychnos potatorum seeds were collected from the tree and were dried at 40 degrees Celsius for 2 days in a hot air oven. These seeds were made into powder by a grinding mill and finely sieved to 150 mesh screen, and then it is used as a natural coagulant. Here we can see the sample picture of Strychnos potatorum seed powder after get grinded into the instrument. Methodology. In this we can see that 500 ml sample taken with known concentration such as nitrogen up to 80 mg per liter and phosphorus up to 10 mg per liter in each beaker. Then we are adding different values of pH such as 4, 5, 6 using 0.1 normality NaOH and 0.1 normality HCl solutions. And then we are proceeding with the different dosage of coagulants in each sample such as 0.2, 0.3 and 0.4 gram per liter. Then the sample made to stir by standard jar test apparatus at 150 rpm with the time noted as 10, 20 and 30 minutes. And then each sample was allowed to settle at different time with a known time such as 30 minutes or 20 minutes depending upon their known concentration. And then finally, the final concentration of the nutrient from each supernatant by using spectrophotometer has been analyzed, and the supernatant was collected and then tested for the further steps. The supernatant is nothing but the clear water which is obtained from the experiment. And then the final step is we are calculating the maximum percentage of nutrient removal by the calibration curve. Preparation of reagents and standard solutions. Zinc sulfate. Dissolve 10 g ZnSO4 7H2O in distilled water and dilute 200 ml. Sodium hydroxide 6 normality. Dissolve 24 g of NaOH and dilute 200 ml. EDTA. Dissolve 50 g of EDTA in 60 ml water containing 10 g NaOH and then cool and dilute 200 ml. Standard ammonium. Dissolve 1.9 g of NHA4Cl dried at 100 degrees Celsius in distilled water and dilute to 500 ml. Dilute 5 ml of the solution to 500 ml. Sulfuric acid H2SO4 at 10 normality. Carefully add 30 ml concentrated H2SO4 to the approximate 60 ml distilled water and dilute to 100 ml. Sulfuric acid H2SO4 at 5 normality. Dilute 14 ml concentrated sulfuric acid to 100 ml with distilled water. Ascorbic acid at 0.1 molarity. Dissolve 1.76 g ascorbic acid in 100 ml with distilled water. Keep at 4 degrees Celsius and then use within a week. Combine the reagents. Mix 50 ml 5 normality H2SO4, 5 ml potassium antimonial tartrate, 15 ml ammonium molybdate solution and 30 ml ascorbic acid solution in order given and at room temperature, stable for 4 hours. Stock phosphate solution. Dissolve 109.7 g anhydrous KH2PO4 potassium dihydrogen phosphate in distilled water and dilute to 500 ml. Standard phosphate solution. Dilute 25 ml stock solution to 500 ml with distilled water. Experimental study. Batch experiment. In this experiment, a conventional jar test apparatus was employed for the test. It had 6 stirrers. Every stirrer was controlled individually. In this test, we can see that 500 ml sample taken in each 1 liter beaker with a known concentration of nitrogen 80 mg per liter and phosphorus 10 mg per liter. The tests were performed at the room temperature and the optimum pH was determined by adjusting of 500 ml a liquid of synthetic solution at different pH such as 4, 5, 6 using 0.1 normality of sulfuric acid and 0.1 normality of hydrochloric acid. Adding different dosage of coagulant in each sample such as 0.2 g per 0.3 g per liter and 0.4 g per liter and made to stir fast as 150 rpm was applied for 2 minutes. The stirring speed was then reduced to 50 rpm for 10, 20 and 30 minutes. And at the end of the low speed period, the mixing was stopped and formed flocks were left to settle down for 15 minutes. The samples to be tested were taken 100 ml from the top of the water level in the beaker, and then for nitrogen add 1 ml of zinc sulfate solution, and then add 0.5 ml of sodium hydroxide to obtain the pH of 10.5. Then allow to settle and filter the supernatant through number 42 Wattman filter paper. Take suitable liquid of samples, add 1 drop of EDTA and then mix well. Then add 3 ml of Nestle's reagent if the EDTA is used and make up to 100 ml. And then again mix well and read percentage transmission after 10 minutes at 410 nanometer in the spectrophotometer and note on the absorbance value. And then proceed with the phosphorus and then take 100 ml of phosphate working solution when ascorbic acid reagent is used as a reducing reagent. Then add 4 ml ammonium molybdate followed by 8 ml combined reagents and dilute to 100 ml with distilled water and then mix well. Then allow to stand for 10 minutes. Measure the intensity of blue colored complex at 690 nanometer or 890 nanometer between 10 to 12 minutes after the development of the color in the spectrophotometer. And then note on the absorbance value. Then repeat the same process for a calibration procedure to make a calibration curve. Results. By the batch experiment, different absorbance values are obtained at different pH, coagulant dosage and contact time. Then the total percentage of removal of nutrients can be obtained by using this relation, such as percentage of removal of nutrients, which gives A1 minus A2 divided by A1 into 100. In this formula, we can see that A1 represents initial concentration and A2 represents the final concentration. In this tabular column, we can clearly see the final concentration of nitrogen with the different coagulant dosage and contact time. And the pH was maintained to be 4, 5 and 6 with the room temperature. And the initial concentration of nitrogen is taken as 80 mg per liter overall the experiment. Here we can see that the bolded numbers denotes the final concentration of the nitrogen as the value of 1 with a contact time of 10 minutes and the coagulant dosage of 0.4 gram per liter at the initial concentration of 80 mg per liter with a pH of 4 with a room temperature. In these trials, the sample were kept at room temperature with the initial concentration of 80 mg per liter normality, which remains the same throughout this process, and all the sample was made to obtain the pH of 4, 5, 6 by using 0.1 normality of hydrochloric acid or 0.1 normality of sodium hydroxide by adding different dosage of coagulant 0.2, 0.3, 0.4 gram per liter into each sample at different settling time 10, 20, 30 minutes, and the final absorbance value can be obtained by the spectrophotometer. Effects of pH on removal of nitrogen. The pH of the aqueous solution is an important controlling parameter in this nutrient removal process. In order to study the effect of pH on synthetic ammonium was varied from 4, 5, 6, the following graph shows the relationship between the different pH and the high percentage of removal. And then in the graph shows that at pH 4 there is a maximum removal of 98.7% and at pH 5 the removal rate is reduced to 98.3% and then further reduced to 97.6% at pH 6. From this figure we can know that the nutrient removal percentage gradually decreases when the pH is increased. This is the representation of the graph. We can see at the lower level the pH range, and at the upper level we can see the percentage of nutrient removal. This shows the effect of pH on nutrient removal at the initial concentration of 80 mg per liter, at the coagulant dosage of 0.4 gram per liter with a room temperature at the contact time 10 minutes. Here we can see that at the pH between 4 to 6, it gradually increases and then decreases and then suddenly decreases. Effects of coagulant dosage on removal of nitrogen. In order to study the effect of coagulant dosage on removal of nutrients, we are introduced different amounts of coagulant in an aqueous solution ranges from 0.2, 0.3, 0.4 gram per liter. This graph shows the relationship between the different coagulant dosage and the maximum removal rate. In this figure, it represents the gradual increase in the percentage of removal of nutrients by increasing the dosage. The maximum removal rate of nitrogen was obtained to be 98.7% using 0.4 gram per liter of coagulant. This is the representation of the graph. Here we can see that from the pH range 0.4 to 0.6, it has been obtained at the pH range of 4 with a room temperature at the contact time 10 minutes with the initial concentration of 80 mg per liter, as said earlier. And the effect of coagulant dosage on nutrient removal was obtained to be at the accurate level of 98.7%. It furtherly increases and then increases. Effect of settling time on removal of nutrients. The maximum removal rate of nutrient can be obtained by kept the solution at different settling time at 10, 20, 30 minutes. The following graph shows the relationship between the settling time and the removal percentage. In the following figure shows that the maximum removal rate at 10 minutes has obtained to be 98.7%. At 20 minutes, the removal rate decreased, and again at 30 minutes, it is increased. This is the representation of the graph. At the initial concentration of 80 mg per liter with the room temperature at the pH 4 with the coagulant dosage of 0.4 gram per liter, the nutrient removal has been first increased and then suddenly decreased, and it again reached to the middle upper stage. It has a gradual increase and gradual decrease. This tabular column clearly represents the final determination of the concentration of phosphorus. In this, the pHs are arranged with the 4, 5, 6 with the three known ranges, and the room temperature is maintained at the same level, and the initial concentration is 10 mg per liter, and the coagulant dosages are varied with the ranges of 0.2, 0.3 and 0.4 mg per liter, and the contact time are maintained with 10, 20 and 30 minutes. Here we can find that the final concentration of phosphorus has been obtained at the level of 5 pH range at the room temperature, the initial concentration of 10 mg per liter, at the coagulant dosage of 0.3 mg per liter with a contact time of 20 minutes, and the final concentration value has been obtained as 2. In these trials, the sample was kept at room temperature with the initial concentration of 10 mg per liter phosphorus with the three trials, which remains the same throughout this process, and all the sample was made to obtain the pH of 4, 5, 6 by using 0.1 normality of hydrochloric acid or 0.1 normality of NaOH. Adding different dosage of coagulant 0.2, 0.3, 0.4 gram per liter into each sample at different settling time, 10, 20 and 30 minutes, and the final absorbance values can be obtained by the spectrophotometer. Effects of pH on removal of nutrient. The pH of the aqueous solution is an important controlling parameter in this nutrient removal process. In order to study the effect of pH on sample was varied from 4, 5 and 6 ranges. And the following graph shows the relationship between different pH and their high percentage of removal. In this figure 4.4, at pH of 4, there's a removal of 77%, and at the pH of 5, there's a maximum removal rate of 80%, and at the low removal rate, it's low at the range of 62% at pH 6. From the following figure, we can clearly know the nutrient removal percentage alternately increases and decreases. This is the representation of the graph. We can see it alternately increases and decreases with a coagulant dosage of 0.3 gram per liter with a room temperature and the contact time of 20 minutes. And the effect of pH on phosphorus removal was known to be 10 mg per liter at the initial concentration. Effects of coagulant dosage on removal of nutrients. In order to study the effect of coagulant dosage on removal of nutrients, we are introducing different amounts of coagulant in an aqueous solution ranging from 0.2, 0.3 and 0.4 gram per liter. And the following graph shows the relationship between the different coagulant dosage and the maximum removal rate. In the following figure shows the maximum removal rate of 80% when using 0.3 gram per liter of coagulant dosage, and the removal rate is low even in the dosage of 0.2 gram per liter and 0.4 gram per liter. This is the representation of the graph, and here we can see at the pH 5 and at the room temperature The contact time has been maintained with the 20 minutes. The initial concentration has known to be 10 mg per liter. The effect of coagulant dosage on phosphorus removal has been identified that it has the gradual increase and then suddenly it decreases. Effects of contact time on removal of nutrients. The maximum removal rate of nutrient can be obtained by keeping the solution at different settling time at 10, 20 and 30 minutes. In this graph, it shows the relationship between the settling time and the removal percentage. In the following figure, it shows that the 80% is the maximum removal rate at the 20 minute and the removal rate is low even in the 10 minute and 30 minute settling time. This graph clearly represents the process which has been taken in the concentration of phosphorus. Here we can find the initial concentration is 10 mg per liter as the constant value and the temperature is maintained at room temperature, pH 5 range, and the coagulant dosage is 0.3 mg per liter. Here we can see up to the pH range, it has been gradually increasing and then suddenly decreasing. Conclusion. The five main operating parameters which influencing the removal rate of nutrients are pH, coagulant dosage and contact time, temperature, initial concentration. In the study, different trials were conducted to determine at which point maximum removal was removed at different operating parameters, as said earlier. The maximum removal efficiency of nitrogen obtained from the results are 98.7% at the pH range of 4 with a dosage of 0.4 gram per liter with a contact time of 10 minutes. And the maximum removal efficiency of phosphorus are 80% with a pH of 5 at the dosage range of 0.3 gram per liter with a contact time of 20 minutes. Our present investigation on removal of nutrients by using Strychnos podatorum seed is more efficient, cost effective, and can further pave the way to develop a technology at large scale to remove the nutrients from the contaminated aqueous environment. It is beneficial and it can be used by all kinds of people, and it is cost effective, as said earlier. It is feasible to all kinds of people. Thank you.